The source of my painting is the subconscious. When I'm in my painting, I'm not aware of what I'm doing. It is only after a sort of get acquainted period that I see what I'm about. The painting has a life of its own. I try to let it come through.
Painting? This was painting? When Jackson Pollock started dribbling streaks and blobs of enamel off the end of a stick or brush, many people thought it was merely a joke. Time magazine called him Jack the Dripper. The general public couldn't understand how Pollock arrived at his peculiar abstract technique. Most people still prefer the realism of an artist like Andrew Wyeth. They feel that Wyeth gets to the heart of his subject and shows it just as it is. When Wyeth does a picture of an old building, you can almost smell the weathered stone and wood. When he does a portrait, the person seems to come alive. This is what most people would call real painting. As a young student, Pollock had started out much closer to traditional realism. His work reflected the influence of his teacher, the Midwestern painter Thomas Hart Benton. But gradually, Pollock turned away from realism in the usual sense of the word. In this painting, the central image almost disappears in a storm of jagged lines and harsh colors. What happened? Pollock had come under the influence of European artists, such as Hans Hofmann. Several of these artists had fled the Nazis at the beginning of World War II, and they brought ideas that were to change the course of American art. One idea was that the innermost feelings of the artist were a valid subject for art and should be expressed as strongly and directly as possible. The colors, lines, and forms used by the artist should represent him rather than some outside object. Another idea was that a painting was essentially a flat surface. A picture that made this flatness obvious would be more honest, more real, than a picture that tried to create a convincing illusion of objects in space. Pollock's drip pictures are flat surfaces. The paint forms continuous all-over patterns across them. And these swirling, leaping runs and splashes vividly convey the explosive energies of Pollock's own personality.